JRay501 here. I'm back in e-news today. Yesterday I did a video with the headlines of several cover-ups, and today I'm going to go into this one. U.S. government was considering plan to evacuate all 90,000 citizens living in Tokyo. The U.S. knew fuel had melted early on via Global Hawk data. So go into read more, and that's just a little snippet. So then we're going to go into the actual article. XSKF, obviously a Japanese link site. U.S. government considered evacuation of 90,000 U.S. citizens in Tokyo. According to Kevin Maher, a U.S. diplomat and the former director of the Japan desk at the U.S. State Department in Japan, the U.S. government considered evacuating all 90,000 U.S. citizens in Tokyo. Now, mind you, he's saying Tokyo, so that doesn't mean all of the citizens that were there. This is 90,000 that were in Tokyo right after the Fukushima 1 nuclear power plant accident. Kevin Maher wrote a book which was to be published on August 17th and is titled Japan That Cannot Decide. If the plan to evacuate 90,000 Americans had been carried out, could have triggered reactions from other foreign governments and caused panic among the Japanese. Maher's book recounts the inside information that Maher obtained as he was part of the special task force with the State Department right after the March 11 disaster, communicating with the Japanese side. The subject of evacuating the U.S. citizen was raised in the early hours of March 16th. The U.S. had already knew about the unusual high temperature of the reactors from the Global Hawk data and determined that the fuel has already melted. The U.S. thought the CAN administration was simply leaving the disaster response to TEPCO, and distrust in the administration was intense. The U.S. high-ranking officials wanted to evacuate the U.S. citizens, but the local officials, including Maher, objected, as it would severely undermine the U.S.-Japan alliance, and the plan was never implemented. It's very heartwarming to know they left 90,000 U.S. citizens in Tokyo under the radioactive plume, which literally rained on them March 15, 16, and 21st for the sake of alliance. I also remember back in March that the U.S. investment bank, Goldman Sachs, flew in high-ranking executives to Tokyo and told its U.S. employees they're in no uncertain terms that they were to stay put in Tokyo or they would lose their jobs. It's pretty much the extent of the article. But the comments: I was in Tokyo at the time. The embassy sent around regular emails to U.S. citizens with advice and news. You didn't have to be much of a detective to see they were holding information back. We got other information, though, other U.S. government channels that, when combined with all the rest of the info, we could find screamed out, get out now. However, I didn't grab my family and head to the Haneda Airport until Monday, 14 March, after Reactor 3 blew up. We got out about 30 hours later. I took a lot of heat from colleagues for acting on incomplete information, but I have no regrets. My family comes first. In times like that, no government will tell you the whole truth because their motivation is not your motivation. People have to think and act for themselves. Yes, and unfortunately, many of us don't think and act for ourselves because we've been trained to look to our government for everything. Interesting timing on this book. The Flygen who worked at Goldman were just released last week. From what I understand, they did get a severance package. This is from my sources inside the industry, which means it's a baseless rumor that it's true. I do know firsthand that anyone who fled without manager approval received no bonus. And as for flying execs in to rally the troops, that happened at a lot of places. Business as usual was the mantra, which seemed strange at the time since some countries were evacuating their citizens. Don't believe any government in the world would behave any different. Of course they wouldn't. Of course they wouldn't. What are we called? Feeders? Eaters? We're called eaters. We're expendable. The Americans did evacuate some 10,000 family members of the military and State Department from Japan in March. And then the U.S. reversed the decision and directed a return to Japan a few weeks later. On what grounds did the U.S. decide to bring 10,000 women and children back to Japan? Were radiation tests of the food chain, air and soil samples on U.S. bases in Japan made? By what organization? Shouldn't these tests be made available to the U.S. public? The U.S. is conducting a body radiation survey of all 60,000 American military personnel and their families in Japan based on models from the Nevada nuclear test experience of U.S. military veterans. It is only a matter of time before concerned Americans and Congress demands to know the results of radiation tests made by the U.S. government, which led to a decision to return so many evacuated families to Japan. That was the advantage for me to be French. The government recommended us to leave if we did not 100% need to stay. So I will leave the link. You can go back in here and read some of these comments. I think my point in reading this is that we need to remain ever responsive and looking into what is going on. I mean, you know, I had heard that the whole entire West Coast of the United States and Canada should have been evacuated. But if they're not going to evacuate 90,000 people from Tokyo, why would they evacuate the whole West Coast, which would mean millions and millions of people, right? Where would we go? Where would they put us? They would lose too much money because we're just eaters. There was an article in here. A comment that I wanted to read. I live 500 miles from Chernobyl and was 3 years old then. By my 20s, several girlfriends of mine had brain cancer, underwent severe procedures and treatments. My mom was a nurse back then at a village hospital. She treated several people who worked on the field in the morning after the explosion for skin problems caused by the fallout. I had a pair, aunt and uncle, who were in a plane from Moscow on a flight above Ukraine on the morning after. Both died from brain cancer in 3 and 9 years. So whoever says the implications of Chernobyl are pure hysteria has no idea about the consequences. Oh boy, yeah. I definitely need to try to see if there's any other information that we can get that would kind of update some of this. I mean, we've basically had one source now for how many months? Arne Gunderson has really been America's, or the world's, only source of any kind of information. Just sad. It's really sad. So, I will try to shed some fresh light on what's been going on. Don't know how successful I will be, but let's see. I do know of somebody that was living in Japan. I don't know if he's stupid enough to stay there. But I will try to contact him and find out. Alrighty. God bless.